So the first thing I'm going to do is boil a couple cups of good quality water in a stainless steel pot. The water is boiling now. I'm going to add a little under a third cup of cheap white sugar. I'm using this cheap white sugar because the culture is going to need simple glucose to feed off of. I think the amount of sugar can vary. This is just the amount that I'm using. So here we go. And you need to stir it up so it doesn't sit on the bottom. It needs to dissolve. The sugar is dissolved, and by the way, there is no sugar in the end result because the culture eats it up and turns it into good acids and all kinds of other good stuff. So now I'm going to add a couple bags of black tea. I'm using this kind of black tea. Found it at an international grocery store. I'm going to get it going here for a second. I'm going to turn the heat off and let it steep for about 10 or 15 minutes. It's been about 15 minutes, the tea is steeped. I went ahead and took the tea bags out. And now we need to put the tea in a jar. The black tea and the kombucha both need to be room temperature, so I went ahead and put some cheesecloth over the jar while I'm waiting for it to cool down. And the reason is you don't want to be pouring cold, good bacteria from the kombucha into the hot tea because you'd kill it. So they both need to be room temperature. I'm just going to let them sit there like that for a little bit, and then I'll come back and pour the kombucha into the jar. The black tea is at room temperature. It only took about 20 minutes. You could also use green tea if you want, but I've always used black. The kombucha, I've had that out for a couple hours, so it's ready to go. Now you can see, I don't know if you can see, but at the bottom there is a lot of good bacteria floating around down there. The cultures at the bottom of the kombucha has floated up to the top, so what I'm going to do is instead of pouring both bottles in, I am going to pour half of each bottle in because the cultures will come out in the first pour. And I want as much culture in there as I can because that's what's going to eat the sugar and turn it into a SCOBY. So here we go. It needs covered with a breathable cloth, like a handkerchief or a cheesecloth or some kind of cotton that lets it breathe but keeps dust and fruit flies out. I went ahead and used cheesecloth. So the final step is to put it somewhere dark and warm. I'm going to use a closet, and you don't want to touch it for a few weeks. When you come back, you should have a SCOBY. It's 5 weeks later and the SCOBY is done. Check that out. I'm guessing it took so long because it's winter time and kombucha takes a little longer when it's cold outside, but it still came out well, so I'm going to use it to make a batch of kombucha. And as long as I continuously to make batch after batch of kombucha, I'll never have to grow a SCOBY from scratch again because every batch will produce a new SCOBY or baby.